In this lesson, we will discuss alternate law, direct law, mechanical backup, and abnormal attitude law. With certain hydraulic system failures, control surface failures, or electronic flight control system, inertial reference, and/or air data computer failures, normal law characteristics and protections may be reduced or lost, and the aircraft will revert to alternate law. Therefore, it is imperative that the pilot fly the aircraft more attentively to avoid exceeding normal flight parameters. ECAM will advise the pilot whenever alternate law is active. The autopilot may or may not be available depending on the nature of the failure. In pitch alternate law, as in normal law, the side stick still demands a G maneuver, and auto trim is still available. Thus, pitch control in alternate law is very similar to normal law. However, the only protection available is the load factor limitation. With no pitch attitude protection, Amber X's replace the double green pitch attitude limit bars on the PFD. Because of the lack of high speed protection and to give the pilot more time to react to an overspeed condition, the high speed envelope is further reduced to 320 knots, Mach 0.77. The system introduces a nose up demand to avoid excessive speed, but may be overridden by the pilot. This limitation is displayed on the PFD speed scale by the black and red VMO strip. In addition, there is an oral overspeed warning at VMO plus 4 or MMO plus 0.006. At the low end of the speed envelope, a nose-down pitch order is added, starting at 5 to 10 knots above the stall, that will gently push the nose over in order to keep the speed from decreasing further. If the pilot continues to pull the stick back, the aircraft will stall, since angle of attack and alpha floor protections are not available. An oral stall warning is generated at an appropriate margin above the stall. The PFD speed scale presentation changes in alternate law. VSW, stall warning speed, rather than alpha prot and alpha max, is displayed at the top of the red and black band. It is also possible, with a combination of failures, to have alternate law without any kind of low-speed or high-speed protections. However, the load factor limitations is always available. In alternate law lateral control, aileron spoiler deflection is always in direct proportion to side stick deflection. Along with the ailerons, only spoilers 4 and 5 are used in order to reduce the roll rate to a comfortable value. If spoiler 4 fails, spoiler 3 is available, and if the ailerons fail, all roll spoilers become active. Yaw damping is still available, however, in manual flight, turn coordination must be accomplished through pilot action on the rudder pedals. Bank angle protection is not provided. Amber X's replace the double green bars on the PFD. Direct law becomes active when, for example, there is a triple inertial reference system failure, or both radio altimeters have failed and the landing gear is selected down. Also, in all cases where alternate law is the active law, as soon as the landing gear is lowered, direct law becomes active. The only exception to this activation of direct law is when alternate law has been activated from an abnormal attitude, which does not put the aircraft into direct law when the landing gear is lowered. Direct law in flight is extremely rare and usually momentary until the crew isolates the associated failed systems. In direct law, both pitch and lateral control is a direct side stick to control surface relationship. There are no protections in direct law, however, oral overspeed and stall oral warnings are still available. The autopilot, yaw damping, and turn coordination are not available, therefore, yaw must be controlled with rudder pedal input. In direct law, auto trim is lost, and trim changes due to speed and configuration changes must be trimmed manually with the pitch trim wheel. The message "Use manual pitch trim" is displayed in amber on the PFD as a reminder. Mechanical backup allows the pilot to control the aircraft in the event of a temporary complete loss of electrical power, complete loss of all 5 flight control computers, or complete loss of elevators, ailerons, and spoiler control. In pitch, this is done by manually moving the horizontal stabilizer by means of the pitch trim wheel. For lateral control, the pilot uses the rudder pedals. On the PFD, the message "Manual pitch trim only" is displayed in red. If the aircraft is thrown out of control due to, for example, clear air turbulence, the abnormal attitude law allows the pilot to bring the aircraft back to within the normal flight envelope. The law becomes active when the aircraft exceeds any of the following limits: pitch attitude greater than 50 degrees nose up or 30 degrees nose down, bank angle greater than 125 degrees, angle of attack greater than 30 degrees or less than minus 10 degrees, airspeed greater than 440 knots or Mach number greater than 0.91, airspeed less than 60 knots or Mach number less than 0.1. The abnormal attitude law in pitch is similar to alternate law, with no protections except load factor protection. Also, auto trim is inhibited when the aircraft is outside of its normal flight envelope. The lateral abnormal attitude law is full direct law with mechanical yaw control only. When the aircraft returns to level flight, pitch alternate law without protections and lateral direct law with yaw damping but no turn coordination is active. As well, auto trim again becomes active. In this lesson, we have discussed alternate law, direct law, mechanical backup, and abnormal attitude law.